Hey, do you need wallpaper? Go to wallpaperboulevard.com. Give them my name, tell them Spencer Colgan sent you, and they'll be sure to give you 10% off at checkout. Check it out, tell them I said hello. They have a tremendous selection. Don't shop anywhere else until you've checked out www.wallpaperboulevard.com. This is Spencer Colgan, and welcome back to my show. My last video, the ceiling video. You see that? You see that discoloration there? I slammed my elbow on the scaffold, and for 30 seconds straight, I felt excruciating pain. So that's what I'm dealing with right now. But what I'm doing today is installing a beautiful wall covering in a bathroom which has textured walls. Let me show you the challenge. Paper hangers don't like this. We don't like this business. First of all, it's unsightly. It's mechanical. Tubing, etc. So, but from a logistical standpoint, it presents a headache for the paper hanger. Okay, see the headache? But how many penetrations do you have? One, two, three. Where you begin the wall covering will either make or break you. Irrespective of any other consideration, this is primary as to where your wallpaper project in this room begins. I'll tell you why. If you happen to miscalculate where your seams go, and your seam begins on this, for this sheet, it begins here. Good luck to you. Good luck to you. So what you want to do is split the headache into two headaches, so that one headache doesn't make you faint. You want the wall covering edge to end somewhere right there, so that you're only dealing with the end of a sheet of wallpaper around this penetration and this one. The idea is to share, to put the edge of the wallpaper in the center of this mess. That's the trick. Oh, and let's add these penetrations. And no, they don't move. Okay. And here's the layout. Like I said, I don't care where the wall covering ends, and I'm talking about, I don't even care if it ends right here. This down here is primary. I don't care if it ends here. That's a challenge if your wallpaper ends right there. But we'll accept it, because that headache can cost you hours. Okay? Here's my first drop. That's an about location where I want the edge, but it's a paste the wall product. I put a copious amount of paste because I don't want this thing slipping once I get it into place. Now, let's try to do it. Okay, so let's start this surgery. So the first cut we'll make is the one at the top here. And for that, I want scissors. You never want to cut up against somebody's sink or whatever, even if you think it's something that will not scratch. That's all I gotta say. It's very important to maintain your plumb line so that you know when you come in like this, this edge is still plumb. It's very hard to determine that when you're negotiating around 50 pipes. Can I tell you something? This is what I love about my job, the challenge. Phil Beckwith. What a nice guy. What a good guy. He's a friend of mine, a paper hanger. No, in the UK they call it decorator. I'm a decorator. I'm not a paper hanger, I'm a decorator. We don't use unsophisticated terms, Spencer. I'm a decorator. Okay, he's a decorator. Let me move you in closer. So we cut with a scissor all the way back to relieve the stress on this piece. And then you saw what I did over here. You always want to, don't cut it exact. You want a little extra room so that you can put the flange underneath the escutcheon. I just love his wallpaper videos. They're like really good. I get my popcorn and I sit down and I watch him for hours. So, I have a little advice for the veteran paper hangers out there who just enjoy my channel, not that I'm teaching them anything. I got a little advice. When you're in a bad situation and your customer walks in, the best way to avoid explaining yourself
And what you're doing is to start singing. It works all the time. Spencer, they never bother you after you start singing. They think it's something like sacred. He's singing. Let me not bother him. And then you buy some time to figure out your problem. Okay, we can kill this. We don't want to kill the battery. I miss my days in New York. Yeah, how you doing? How you doing? You hang wallpaper?
Yes.
You remove wallpaper?
Yeah.
Then comes the doozy. So you hang and you remove, right?
Yeah. At that point, I'm like, nasty. Yeah.
What's the matter with you?
And then you get into an argument with the guy. And he has no idea how stupid he sounds.
Yeah.
Going around pipes is all about relieving stress. That's really all you're doing. You know? You're relieving stress so that you can join your trimmed material. And if you do that well, you got a good job. Alright? I'd rather just take all of these things apart. Alright, buddy. Alright, man. What do you think, folks? It's so beautiful.
I never thought I would like being in a bathroom.
Oh my gosh, this is not easy. All right. Can you guys see all that action? Good. So let me just tell you guys something. A lot of you are sending me emails, which is fine. However, you have to realize something. I don't have the time to answer everything I'm sent. So, I do respond to the donations, though, pretty quickly. Just kidding. A lot of people don't realize that in addition to being a great wallpaper installer, I'm a family man. And you know, you gotta come home and be ready. You know? In the police department, we used to call it being 98. I'm 98, Central.
You gotta be ready. You know, baby needs a diaper change, right? Kid needs a little hug, right? Well, what happens is, I'll get an email from a YouTuber. Hi, Spencer. I get one of two types. One who lies and says, I watch all your videos, you're the best. And then asks me a question, which is in every single video I post. And the other one, they don't bother complimenting me. They're more realistic. Hey, where'd you get that tool that you posted in the last video? Send me the information on my email. If not, text it to me. I get that a lot. And those are the ones that go in the junk folder quickly, real quick. Ooh, quickly. You know? It's like, excuse me, I got a life here, you know? One woman actually had the nerve, to say, I can't watch your videos, you grunt too much. You know, what kind of people are out there, man? I grunt too much. She says, yeah, you're making me sick. I make you sick. How dare you? How dare you? I make you sick, huh? I make you sick. What do you think you're doing to me? You know? And then I'll get emails. Hi, I grew up in Missouri. We had no wallpaper there. My grandfather was a farmer. I just go right to the second paragraph. And then my mother, she had post-traumatic stress disorder. Then I go to the third paragraph, hoping the saga will end and they'll get to the point. By the fifth paragraph, and my cousin is a police officer in LA, and he loves it. And then I just delete the email. Then I'll get a follow-up email. Hey, did you get my email? I asked your question. And I'm like, oh, you were the one that wrote that tome, T-O-M-E. Look it up. Thank you. And, you know, I don't know what to say to these poor people, you know? Oh, gosh, what do you think? That question. I get too many negative responses.
Well, first of all, you're wasting my time with all your stories.
All right, if you really want to know. No, I don't want to know. I want you to use a mental reservation and only tell me what I want to hear. I don't want to hear what you don't like. That doesn't make me feel good. All right? Just so you know. I wanna hear your anger. Okay.
Nicey, nice. Okay. Okay, so now we're going to just trim the bottom. And then we'll show you the result thus far. By the way, you guys know that I have a PhD, right? I never really tell anybody on my channel because I feel like I'm bragging. You know, education is not something everybody esteems these days. But anyway, I have a PhD, a paper hanging diploma from one of the best schools in the continental USA, Colgan University, based in Florida. And my professor loved me. We think alike. And he's a great guy. We still talk. Okay. Let me show you how it's come out so far, so that you can applaud me. 1 second. So far, this is what we're dealing with. Can you just take 1 minute and write W-O-W below? Do that for me. W-O-W. And if you really want to be nice, put an exclamation mark after the last W, please. So I didn't want to bore you with the details of just hanging that sheet. The next sheet, we're going to get to it. Over there, around the light. And then joining the seam here. And so you join me as I now attempt to go around the sink. If you have heavy wall covering, don't let the tension tear this here. You want to keep your eye on this cut there, okay? How do you like it so far? Doesn't it look nice? Now, the trick is not to overlap at your seam. And that's the tendency to do that. So what I recommend is you put a lot of paste on the wall so that you can slide your wall covering. Just take my advice. Put a lot of paste on the wall so that you can slide your material. Because not enough paste will make the job a lot harder, okay? Okay. Man, where's my blade? So you need a long blade. Even if you have half a blade left, just pull it out and get a new blade. Can you tell when I'm in a mood? Like right now. I'm not too happy right now. I don't like when sweat drips into my eyes. Okay. Oh, damn it. I've got to take off the tension here. Easy, folks. This is not easy. Okay. Alright. So, we're going to do something unusual and work from the bottom up, since that's where our wall covering joins first. It joins at the bottom. And so, by all means, start at the bottom. Okay? Okay. So that's what I'm doing. I'm joining it here at the bottom because it meets here. You can see why it doesn't meet, right? We're dealing with tension, so she meets at the bottom. There's less tension. Makes sense, right? Let me try to bring in this close. Does that work out for you? Let me make sure that you can see. I don't think that big pipe in the way is helping you out. How about over here? How's that? Okay, I think you get the idea. How about if I try to just move you right in front of the thing? I'm gonna watch where the camera records. What do you think? No? Alright. If that works, that's what we'll do. Put a rag in front of my camera so that you don't slide. Hand is up here. I think you can see all the action. I think. Pull the escutcheon out. Anytime you can pull the pipe out a little bit, you take advantage of it. Take advantage of it. Believe me. Alrighty. Very nice. When you're trimming the wall covering, make sure you trim it as close to the pipe as possible, because you wind up trimming too much of it off. Okay. Alrighty. And you don't want to do that. Okay. Let's see. Put that back. Whoa. What do you think? Clean this up. Now, let's take you away. Okay. So far, so good. Now, see this? In line with this rail, you want to cut the wall cover. Right up to the thing, right up to it. Okay. And you're gonna do that all the way around it. You wanna do that all the way around it so that you essentially come up with something of a perforated radius of sorts. You can see now all I have to do is trim where my cut points meet where metal meets wall. So that all you have to do is put that up against there, and with the other hand, trim where smoother meets metal. Now, after trimming away the bottom, pushing again our seam together, what I'm going to do is put my head against the floor and trim this. Okay, and I'm gonna try to let you see it as I do it. All right. Camera doesn't wanna stay up, but we'll make it. How's that? Put you in an angle. I think that'll help. Okay, let's try to do this. You know what I need? I need a helper. Try to get a guy.
Okay. Whenever you rise up.
Yes.
I've got some Allen wrenches from a neighbor that I'd be willing to bet one of these will fit.
Nice. We'll tighten. Yeah, we'll tighten it up. We put together a Christmas gift, and of course, I left this beautiful new set home.
That's what I told him. He said he's not happy about that.
No, you know, that's okay.
But I'll just lay them right here, and hopefully one of those will fit.
Oh, really? You think so?
Well...
Okay.
It's a whole set.
All right. Yeah.
Or kind of a small set, but
it's
a set. So.
I always have tools. I pride myself on, like, I get the best stuff. But
I've got a good set of tools. Like I said, they're all in storage. But my neighbor's got a pretty good set, so he had these. So hopefully, if those don't fit, then we're out.
All righty. Thank you.
But I've got a feeling they got some smaller than what I have, so I've got a feeling.
I appreciate it. You know what I need to be able to do? Levitate. I need to be closer to the area I'm cutting. You know, it's important to know. Let me try to get up there closer. Okay, that'll help me if I got closer like that. So what I'm doing is perforating the product. And I find if you don't perforate it, you'll overcut. Now, let's talk about the cost of labor. If you don't price this job out properly, you're basically doing it for free. You have to realize how long this is going to take. And there's something called, not only for your labor, there's something called the aggravation factor. How much is it going to aggravate you? So I'm using the impression that I made on the wall covering to trim it. And that worked. Let's try it on the other side. Alrighty. Hey, whatever works, you know. Okay, let's see. This is not easy, folks. You know, it takes the fun away from the job. Again, I'm following the impression that I made. What do you think? Let's wash it up and ask you what you think.
How about that, huh?
Hello, we're leaving.